Hey friends, Jill here. Welcome back to Whispering Willow Farm. Today, Nathan and I are gonna show you guys how to install an arch trellis with a cattle panel. I really wanna show you guys just how easy and versatile it is. Before we hop into that though, I wanted to kind of share with you guys some of the things that I find really appealing about vertical gardening. For many years, I never ventured into vertical gardening, and it's because I didn't realize how valuable it was. So through the years, and seeing friends do it so well and just how versatile it was, I have really incorporated this a lot in my raised bed garden, and it's something that I just find easy. It's beautiful. There's just so many wonderful aspects to vertical gardening, and it's really cheap, really affordable. So I just want to talk to you guys real quick about some of the benefits of vertical gardening, why I choose to do it, and then we'll get busy installing it. The first one would be if you're limited on space, it is a really, really good option. When you think about having a raised bed, you know, and say you just have a small bed, maybe your bed's only 6 foot long, or maybe your bed's only 4x4, anything you want to grow in the actual bed you can. And then by adding that arch, you can just plant the arch and then let it climb up, so you're able to literally double your space. So I would definitely say if you're in a small space and you're wanting to max it out, definitely look into vertical gardening, because something that I do is I will plant my entire bed, and I'll even plant stuff on either side of the trellis and then plant the trellis itself. So typically I'll have my cucumbers or my tremoncino squash vining up the arch trellis, and then the bed right here, I've got my tomatoes, you know, I've got my bush beans, I have whatever else it is that I'm growing, and I find that they don't ever really compete for nutrients. I'm typically always fine. And so it's just a really good way to maximize a small space. Another major benefit to vertical gardening, for Nathan in particular, is how easy it is to prune and take care of. So when you think about bending over, maybe you're in a position where you have a bad back, maybe it's just hard for you, that bending over to prune your plants, to harvest your plants, to tend to your plants, just physically takes a toll on your body. Obviously, like, gardening is something that you want to do for fun, maybe it's a hobby, you're not wanting to, you know, spend the day gardening and then go inside and immediately regret that decision because your back hurts or something like that. So Nathan has a hard time bending over. He has really bad lower back problems. So when you think about putting things on an arch trellis and growing it upwards, it's just a lot easier to harvest that, to prune that. I also notice that you find issues much quicker and you're able to address them as far as pest management, which we'll hit on that in a second. But overall, I have found that for some reason, my plants that are on that arch trellis, I tend to better. I harvest the fruit when it is at peak harvest instead of letting it get overgrown, maybe because I just missed it. If it's a cucumber, you know, I've had Armenian cucumbers before that I've harvested that are huge because I just missed them because they all started vining on top of each other, and it's, you guys know, it's just easy to let that get away from you. So I found that it is much easier for me just to prune and harvest and really just maintain my plants better when they are up vertically. It's also really stinking pretty. You guys know I love growing food because it brings me joy, but I love the way the garden makes me feel, and there is something about coming out here. As soon as I started incorporating arch trellises in my garden, it immediately transformed my space. So if you are in this where you're gardening and it's fun and you want to be sustainable, but you also want a place of refuge that you can go to, you want a place where you feel rejuvenated, you want a gathering place for your friends and your family, you can really make a garden so, so beautiful by adding some arch trellises, adding some chairs, just really making it be your space. That's something that I do every year. I start going in and I'm adding flags, I'm adding decorative pots. We've got the arch trellises, and I'm really making this an inviting, captivating space for friends and family to just kind of relish in all the hard work I put in all season. Another huge benefit is you just have less disease and better airflow by getting those plants upright. They're not, so say for instance, a lot of times disease happens when there's a lot of moisture that has set in. So say you've got some sort of melon or a cucumber and it's vining on the ground and it rains a lot and you've got that, you know, fruit that's rotting now on the ground, you've got that vegetable that's rotting on the ground, you're just not getting the proper airflow, you're having a lot of disease. I've found that my plants that are vertical trellises, I just have less disease, and I think it really is just because the airflow is much better. And then when I do have some sort of disease most of the time, or maybe I'm having really hard pest pressure, because I am going through and I can see it, like you know, up close instead of bending down and trying to look for the problem, I find that I find the problem quicker and I'm able to treat it to where it's not taking over my whole crop. So whether that be, you know, squash bugs, I'm able to see them. I hand pick off the eggs. You know, if there's some sort of aphid, I can see that problem. And it's just a lot easier for me to address and solve the problem before it overruns and takes over a crop and then it's no longer good for me. So I definitely have less pest pressure, mainly because you're not having all those ground dwelling pests on there. You have the better airflow, which obviously is going to be better for your plants. If the leaves get wet from a hard rainfall, they dry out faster, which is just eliminating disease and fungus and all those other issues with your plants. So it really is just pretty beneficial. It just adds this aesthetic, you know, look to your garden that kind of is really just magical, is the only way I know how to express it. Now, I do want to hit on the type of fencing our cattle panel to use. We use cattle panels. We buy them for $20 at our local co-op. You can buy them at pretty much any farm store. I will say though, in the past we have used fencing. And while you can use fencing for some trellising, I would avoid using it for any overhead, so the arch trellises. And the reason I say that is we had an entire bed full of fencing and I grew a whole bunch of green beans on it. And it just wasn't sturdy enough. So what happened is the top kept collapsing. We ended up, I had a storm come through and the entire fencing just fell down overnight with beans on it. It was kind of a nightmare. So if you want to use that, you know, long ways in your garden, maybe to tie up tomatoes on or something like that, I think it would be fine. But if you're looking for that arch overhead support, make sure that you are looking for a sturdy option. I have found that cattle panels works best for me. Obviously, if you have something comparable in your area, seek that out. Just think about something I always ask myself is, what am I going to put on this? Will it withstand? As much fruit's gonna be grown. And that's just something I think about, especially my tromboncinos. I grow a ton of tromboncinos. They get really long and big. I'm gonna need a sturdy, you know, cattle panel or sturdy fencing arch trellis system to make sure that it's gonna hold up all of, you know, all the squash that are on there. Otherwise, it ends up kind of being a disaster. So those are just some things to kind of keep in mind when you're shopping around and looking for different options. Obviously, if you can reuse some materials you guys have, do that. We've done, you know, hog panels before and made it work for things like my cucamelons that really weren't that heavy. So there's definitely some wiggle room in it. Just be mindful of what you're planting on it. So with that being said, let's head to the garden, grab Nathan, and we'll show you guys just how easy it is to install. So the supplies you need to do an arch trellis are really simple. You are going to need 4 T-posts, like Nathan has got here. We do the 6-foot T-post. You can go from 4 foot all the way up to like 10 foot. We choose to do 6 foot because Nathan's the one that's having to drive these in the ground and he obviously doesn't want to have to drive them down forever. We also don't want the arch to be too big. So we try to figure out, the cattle panels we buy are 16 foot. We want to make sure that they're not, that they're tall enough to where Nathan can comfortably walk through them, but that they're not too tall to where I can't harvest, you know, whatever it is that's on there. So our arch trellises are 7 foot tall. Our walkways are around 4 foot. So we're gonna obviously have our trellises going over our walkways. If you are in the beginning stages where you're figuring out your beds, your trellises, things like that, obviously the wider your walkways are, the shorter that your trellises are going to be. Like I said, Nathan's out here helping me. He obviously wants to comfortably be able to walk through these and not have to duck and things like that. So that is something that, if vertical gardening is something you're wanting to do, be mindful of how wide your walkways are if you're wanting to add trellises on them.
Okay. So I'm spacing these T-posts about 48 inches apart because we bought the cattle panels and the cattle panels are 52 inches tall, I guess. And so I'm going to space them 4 foot apart. That way there's a little bit of overhang on each side.
And how deep are you driving the T-post?
Because we're bowing them, you know, there's quite a bit of tension. So about 2 foot in the ground.
Okay.
And I learned this the hard way last time. You want them straight, otherwise your arch doesn't look right. So I'm gonna have to redo this.
Yeah, especially if you are adding more than one trellis at a time, the placement of the T-post makes a difference on if they line up correctly or not. All right, so now I'm gonna help Nathan and we are just going to put up the arch trellis. I would encourage you to have another hand, another person helping you do this because you are having to put tension on it. So we will be placing the cattle panels on the inside of the T-post, as you guys can see right here. So that does put quite a bit of tension if you're doing it by yourself trying to get it in. So I would just encourage you, maybe have another set of hands around. All right, so now you're going to take the clips. And how often are you putting them on there?
I just put three.
You just put three per pole?
Yeah.
Per T-post? Okay.
Just to keep it from slipping.
Yeah. Y'all, we just put up a beautiful arch trellis in what? How long did that take us? Not very long at all. And it's so pretty. I have no idea what I'm going to put on it.
Guys, I'm gonna be real with you. This is super easy, but I've done every other one of these with a hammer.
That is true.
I bought T-post drivers today because I told her I'm not spending 30 minutes hammering in T-posts today.
So. That is true. So I will say,
work smarter, not harder.
That's right. A T-post driver makes it a lot better. But look at this. This is like so beautiful. It's just made my day. So while Nathan is just securing the clips for extra support, you guys can see here, we did that really, really quickly. Four T-posts, one cattle panel, and a T-post driver. And now we have a beautiful arch walkway in the garden. I really hope if you guys have been kind of thinking about adding arch trellis or vertical gardening into your gardening style, I really hope that encourages you just how simple and easy it is. And you guys have seen my arch trellises. It just can really transform a space. It can make it easier on your body, on what you're doing, and how you can prune and harvest. And there's so many just wonderful benefits to vertical gardening, in my opinion. So I hope this encourages you guys. If you're wanting to do it, just do it, because it really is just that simple. But thanks for hanging out with me today. I'll talk to you soon.